What is going on, guys? Welcome back to Hippo Supercoach on this fine Sunday morning. And today we're going to be discussing some games from today. So very interesting results. We see the Suns and the Giants get up. Let's go through the Gold Coast game first. So we got to talk about Matt Rowe. So 137 Supercoach. Pretty unbelievable effort. 20 clearances. Now, is he going to do this every game? Absolutely no chance. But still, he looked unbelievable. If he didn't have the bye, early bye, I would probably have him in my team. But due to that bye, I just can't do it. Flanders, in my opinion, is worth it because he's a forward. So Flanders 124, 26 disposals. Really good game from him. Only had the three clangers. So yeah, I don't know what's loading on my computer. But yeah, Flanders is locked in for me. I saw enough. Will Power's another one to really consider. So playing intercept, I'm probably going to wait till after his bye to see how the role looks in a couple of weeks. But right now it looks very, very good. So keep an eye on Will Power. Anderson and Tuke also went large. So those guys are two guys that you could definitely start. But like I said, that bye is just so friggin' annoying. But Tuke Miller, like, he's probably the safer bet out of the two. Moving down, Buderick played well, 94. I wouldn't go near him, but I could see why people like him. And then Ulin is not really a pick. Sexton, 73, so started off a bit slow. The role's really good, so don't worry about that. Just lock him in. Moving on to Richmond. Jaden Short, 130. So this is another talking point. Early buy, which hurts, has for all these players. But look, I think he'll go close to top six. But I probably wouldn't pick him just because of that early buy. I'd rather jump on him later, even if I have to pay an extra 30-40k for him. Boston, I think, is a bit of a trap. One thing that is true is Gold Coast hit 15 behinds. So Short and Boston had like 7 kick-ins each, which is just mental. And that's not going to happen every week where they're going to have that many behinds conceded on them. I wouldn't have thought. So yeah, a bit of unrealistic scores there from Short and Boston. Who else is there? So Gibkiss, or Naismith, 93, lock him in as your R3. I know he could not make any money, but I think, look, if Nate comes back, say round three, kicks him out, whatever. If Nate gets hurt again, then we have Nate, a guy that's on the bubble, and he's going to come in, and he's going to fucking make us a lot of money. So yeah, Nate's pretty injury prone too, I think. So yeah, lock in Naismith. There's no other good options anyway. Ow, fuck. Gibkiss, I think you have to pick him. Plain simple, 76. He did enough, 150k. Yeah, that's enough for me to jump in, to throw him in. I wouldn't probably field him every week, but yeah, very good score, very good Supercoach Dream Team ratio, only 9 disposals. Shai Bolden, I wouldn't go near. Seth Campbell's another one we probably have to consider. 70 Supercoach. He's definitely not going to get dropped. He played really well. Thompson Dow, what a trap. 72% game time, 23 Supercoach. So yeah, glad I didn't have him. Taranto, terrible, man. He's terrible. What is going on with fan footy nowadays? Giants v Pies, let's go through it. Yeah, of course, it's error 404. You've got to be joking me. Okay, here we go. So let's talk about GWS first. So like I said, all these players have early buys, so it's freaking annoying. Tom Green, however, he's really tempting me. 30 disposals, 6 tackles. He's going to be one of the best midfielders this year for Supercoach. I'm sure of it. Only had the one clanger, which is pretty good. Lockie Ash, fuck you, man. Seriously, I jumped on you last year when you had about 1% ownership and you pumped out 50s. Now you want to go 130. So I think I was a year early on Ash. Friggin' annoying. Cogs, trap, I think. Briggs, very good Supercoach Dream Team ratio. Only 14 disposals and fucking went 109. That's mental. Whitfield's another one, 137 Dream Team, 108 Supercoach, but yeah, he looks good. Jacob Ware, probably not the pick. Cadman, I'm not sure about him. Harvey Thomas, probably not. Yeah, I don't know about some of these guys. Josh Kelly, probably not. Moving on to Collingwood, Darcy Cameron went nuts, but I wouldn't go near him. Nick Dacos did what Nick Dacos does. Yeah, great game from him. He's a lock. Maynard, no. No one else really relevant from Collingwood that I can... Oh, Charlie Dean, 55. Yeah, look, I don't love his job security, but I don't know too much about him either. I didn't look that good. Anyway, let's get into my team. This is it after round zero. Bang. So, what are we going to discuss? Now, I haven't got all the right rookies, but this is sort of how I'm looking. I'm trying to steer away from... You know what? Let me have a spoonful of my protein powder oats while you guys digest the team. Yeah, so... I like this structure a lot. No Heaney. Look, I think Heaney might be a trap. I heard John Lomwire say something like, he will play, like we tried to get him forward, but he was playing so well in the midfield, which means ultimately they're going to put him back on the forward line. So I don't think he's worthwhile. I've currently got Butters. I'm not set on that pick at all. But yeah, trying to stay away from the round zero traps, even though they're not really traps, but they're just like, it's like you get a price rise out of them. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you see them play in the real stuff, so they're very easy to pick because you know their role and you know it's good. But with these round one guys, it's like you don't know for sure. It's risky in a way, but you do, it's like risk to reward because you're gonna have a premium that doesn't have an early buy. So that's what I'm trying not to bite on these early round zero guys. I think you guys know what I mean. I'm not really wording it very well, but yeah, happy with the structure, happy with the primos. If I've got four keepers in the back line, three in the mid, so that's seven, two in the rucks, nine, 10, 11, Flanders and Fisher, I think, are keepers. So still a lot of keepers for a decent value team, I think. But yeah, happy with the way the team looks at this point. Try not to overthink too many moves in the next week. It's going to be hard, obviously, but I think we've seen all the intel we're going to get now, so we can really start cementing these final teams. I know there's so many people, final team, this is my final team, but now it's really going to be the last. So, yep, thank you guys for watching. Have a good day on this Sunday, and I'll see you in the next one.